Hi, myself Gautami. Today in this tutorial, we will learn how to paint sea with sky, clouds and dolphin. And here we will learn how to paint sea waves and splashes of waves. And here canvas size is 3 feet by 4 feet. 3 feet is height and 4 feet is width. You can use any size of canvas, and I'm using oil paint. You can use acrylic also. First, I have applied liquid titanium white. I have created this by mixing linseed oil and turpentine oil in titanium white, and spread it all over the canvas where I have to paint sky, so that color will spread easily. Then I have used ultramarine blue color and Persian blue color mixed with titanium white. For darker shade of blue, I have used Persian blue with for lighter shade, I have used ultramarine blue or Persian blue mixed with titanium white. Currently I am using a wide brush of size 2 inch. This is a white bristle brush because it is base layer, so I am using this white bristle brush so as it will be easy to spread colors with it. I am just leaving some gaps in between the colors so that it will look good when you merge it, because sky is not even in color sometimes. On some portion it is lighter and some it is darker. Generally in corner it is darker. It also gives look of a little bit cloud when you leave gap in between the colors. Then after that I've started creating base layer for sea, and same process we have to follow for sea also. If you want, you can apply a little bit titanium white on. And if you don't want, then at least mix linseed oil and titanium and turpentine oil in your color so that it can spread easily. If you want, you can also give a base layer with acrylic colors. So first we need to cover the white part of canvas with the base layer of whatever base color or most of the color we have to apply on canvas, that we can use for base layer. So here sky is almost blue and my sea color is also almost blue. So I am using different shades in base color also, but they are mostly of blue and mixed with Algerian crimson for darker blue, and for lighter blue I have mixed a little bit titanium white. And sometimes I have also used a teal color. I have also applied a masking tape for making sea line straight. Now you can see that I am applying teal color, which is you can make it by mixing blue and little bit yellow and titanium white in this. So different shades when we have to create on sea also, but for base layer we are mainly using blue and titanium white and teal color. I'm just giving a rough sketch over for dolphin. Later on I will change its shape little bit, like its width, or maybe if I'm not satisfied with some positions of any wings of dolphin, then we can change it. But roughly I am just sketching over here, like the position of the dolphin, how it will look. In this sketch there are two dolphins and I'm creating a basic shape for them. So for this I have used my flat brush of this is a mongoose hair brush, because it is easy in sketching if we use soft brush. And since there is a base layer, I have already applied base layer, so it's better to use any soft brush. Otherwise a white bristle brush can scratch your color if it is wet. So I have used light gray color for sketching. You can use any color, similar color like blue, or I have used gray because my dolphin colors are also almost gray, so I have used gray color and mix a little bit linseed oil, and we have to define shape and position of these dolphins. Later on we will define more and refine it. This is base layer of it, and for this I have used titanium white and ivory black and Persian blue, and I have used Algerian crimson and titanium white for lighter part. But right now for darker shade I am using mostly Persian blue, black and titanium white. Here I am not satisfied with the bottom portion because this is more thick, so I have to remove that sketch. So for that I have just applied sky color over there and can easily remove that. In oil paint you can easily change your painting if it is wet. After getting dry also you can change, but when it is wet it is very easy to change your painting. So I'm using here synthetic brushes, of flat synthetic brushes, and size 4, 6, and 2, 3 brushes I am using for different colors to make it faster. For spreading colors I'm using some brush. For merging different colors I'm using another brushes. So mostly you can use synthetic brush over here, or you can use any red sable hair brushes or mongoose hair brushes. You can use fine brushes. Mostly it is better to use if you are working on next layer. So here this is the base layer for your dolphins, and mostly I am trying to define its shape and give basic shape of a dolphin. Here in top I have used darker shade, and for bottom I have used lighter shade, and because it is coming to in light, and also the according to fish skin tone I am creating it. So it's not necessary to create only natural colors. Create your own colors. Mainly you can choose any other color also. It's not important which color you are using, or main importance is light and shadow effect, and making it in 3D, or how we can show that there is sunlight reflecting on some portion, or their main shape, whether it is round or flat or something like that. So for that we have to keep in mind that how we can make. Like you can see that if I am given here I have given shadow little bit in this side, then it becomes round and again cylindrical form. Again if I am giving shadow here, then it is turning into bottom portion. So main importance is to show sunlight light reflection on any object or any item. Here just it is base layer. Later on I will define more painting base layer and defining the structure of the second dolphin, which is on upper side, which is an upper layer, maybe you can say that, or it is in front of or more closer to viewer. So its size is bigger, and but colors are almost same, and I'm using same color which I have used previously, like gray color, by mixing titanium white, ivory black and Persian blue. I have made in gray color over here, and for lighter color I have used Algerian crimson mixed with titanium white and little bit blue. So here again I am using same brushes. I'm just showing both dolphins so that you can see different angles of creating fish or dolphin. Important part again is to make it embossed or make it in round shape, or it should look like 3D, not flat. And later on when we add more layers, then it will become more embossed and it won't look flat at all. We have also give shine onto fish because they are coming from water, so they will not be a flat color. And so we will add a shine and gloss later on in other layers. How to paint clouds of different shapes, sizes, how to make them fluffy, and how to make them merged with the sky. Means if we don't want very dense clouds, then how we can create that, and if we want dense clouds, then how we can create that. So different shapes and sizes and colors of clouds we see really on in a sky, and it depends on the sunlight and the time. According to that their reflection will be. So first I am creating clouds. I am using titanium white, and if don't use only titanium white, you can mix a little bit blue in this, because if in first layer if you use pure titanium white, then it will look more chalky and flat. And if you want to make it fluffy, then you have to add different shades and shadow and light clouds. So for here, first for creating base layer or for clouds, I am using titanium white mixed with a little bit blue. I am using my old filbert brush, which is spread it out for this. And you can use a fan brush or any flat brush also you can use, in which you are more comfortable, you can use that. Mostly for me it is filbert brush, and usually this is the old filbert brush because its strokes are not very specific, and it will be fluffy. So that's why I'm using it. And after applying one layer, I just smudge it softly with any wide soft brush, and smudge it softly and blend it a little bit with the sky. And again then after that you can apply next layer on it, like you can add more shadow in it, then after that you can add more light reflection on it. So first I am creating different shapes of clouds and defining their positions, areas, and then later on I will add more depth and on these clouds. Don't make similar shapes of clouds, make some varieties of clouds, and you can add more lights on it, different color reflections, like you can add a little bit yellow cat or yellow ochre in titanium white, or you can also mix sometimes a little bit red in titanium white to give different shades. If you are creating clouds of sunset or sunrise, then you have vast range of colors, like purple or orange or red you can use in that color, or yellow also. But when you are creating clouds for 12 o'clock or 2 o'clock, then there will be less colors in clouds. Mostly they will be white, gray, and little bit blue. So create a paint according to your time. Smudge lightly with flat brushes or soft flat brushes. Usually top clouds are more dense, and bottom clouds are mostly flat or of same color, and but the top clouds are more fluffy and of different shades and different shapes. Bottom clouds are usually linear and flat. Smudge it gently and spread a little bit outside as it's spreading on the sky. Then it will add more realistic look and dramatic look.